It was actually during my senior year. I was working in an immunology lab with several friends, and we were focusing on Mohawk gene variation inside mice and how it actually affects children and adults. So in that moment, I realized that, you know, this eventually is going to lead to that potential treatment to help, you know, LCMV, people who are affected by LCMV, which is a virus. And I just knew then, I was like, you know, this is where I really want to go. I want to be more in the administrative and regulation side instead of the research aspect of it. I feel like on a personal level, I have unique viewpoint in the fact that my undergraduate degree was solely on research. You know, if it didn't focus on necessarily using the research for a medical treatment later on down the road, but how we can advance science that would eventually lead to future treatments. But with a regulatory science degree, I'm on the other end of the spectrum where I mostly focus on how does the outcome of the study affect patients? How does it affect, you know, physicians and other individuals within that field? So I kind of get both aspects of the coin that leads to eventual medical treatment advancements. You know, getting a master's degree in general is a big accomplishment. I feel like for me, that's kind of where I've been focused on. But I think the biggest accomplishment is actually kind of been the networking factor that I've been able to discuss, you know, ethical and moral questions with professors who have worked in the field. And also to give my insight on things that are currently playing out. And I feel like that is a big accomplishment because it's something I can take forward with me in my career, knowing that I have the skill set to actually have those conversations with other individuals who are working in the field currently.